This is a quick little video on a print and cut workflow solution, and I'll explain it to you. It's real brief. I make my samples in the print and cut at 12 by 18. The images inside here all have kiss cuts, and I have the kiss cuts set, let's say 75 on the pressure. Then I have perf cuts. There's two perf cuts. One is this little tab side, which goes right there, which you see is fallen out, which is not what I want to happen. And then the entire image itself is a perf cut. So I have two perf cuts. The way I recommend setting this up, this was set up incorrectly, and that's why I'm mentioning it. The way this sets up best is, first you have your kiss cuts. Those are at the top of the list. Those go first. You do all your kiss cuts first. Then what you want is two perf cut or through cut, so that when you through cut or perf cut, you can use the terms interchangeably, flex cut, what you want to do is you want this, all of these, to perf cut first. And you want your settings so that the length and your tabs and your depth, and you can use a combination of those settings, allow this to retain inside of here because you want this to stay put. You don't want it falling out. When I hand these out, I want this perf cut to stay in. But I want you to be able to take your finger and tap it hard and it will come out. Then I want this to be looser, to fall out a little easier, but I don't want it to fall out so easy that they come out during the printing. I also set them up so that you have four across and say four deep. I usually put a half an inch between them because I need to maintain the integrity of that film so that it doesn't fall apart into this sort of lattice work that collapses on itself while it's perf cutting these. So what I want really are two separate perf cut colors and one set to one tab, one length and one tab length, and then also a different depth also. And then this one I want to just barely hang on until the job is finished, because I want these to come out with just a tap, and they're pretty easy, almost sort of falling out as it goes forward, but not falling out at the first one, because if they start doing that, they can kind of get slide behind the other images. And I recommend setting up two separate through cut or perf cut or flex cut for that. I usually call it perf cut colloquially, so that you have three separate lines. This one I would do, say, in pink, this one around here in a lime green, and then the stuff inside of here I might do in blue. It doesn't matter what color, just so that you use a consistent color and you know what they are. And then I'll see all three of them, and then in the order that I want them done. And then you can even use the feature in Flexi that will show you the finished order that they're going to cut in if you just hit the little button that, you know, walks you through all the steps visually, that it's going to do the kiss cut, and then the inner perf cut at a specific setting, and then the outer perf cut at another specific setting. Just a simple little workflow recommendation, because I had all these falling out and I've been playing around with the settings, and I figure I would just communicate it to you so you have a little more understanding of doing, you know, more complex perf and kiss cuts that the cutter and the printer are certainly capable of doing with our new print and cut software.